Hi, today is Saturday. Welcome. Hi. Today I didn't do anything. Like, I wanted to go out, but I didn't. I didn't do anything today. Yeah, I was just catching up on all the videos that I didn't watch on YouTube. So, I was like catching up on all the videos. Yeah, I told you, right? I like catch up on all the videos together. There are some videos left, so I'll probably do that tonight. Yeah, so after my walk, I didn't go for walk today, so I'll probably go for walk now and catch up on all the videos. So some days are just like low-key like this, where I just watch content online. Yeah, and my favorite thing to watch on YouTube is BookTube. So I watch BookTube like all the time. I'm so interested in watching BookTube. I love watching BookTube. That's the only thing I watch on YouTube. So there are like few people that I religiously follow. I watch all their videos. Yeah, so I was watching all that today. Yeah, so that's what I did today. Yeah, it is a very silent, low-key, ordinary day. Yeah, and I just realized, like, I was like going through Goodreads, like few of the fantasy books, like I was going through that online, and I just realized that a lot of fantasy books has violence, and like a lot of things happen in that book, and I think I should just be okay with the fact that there is going to be violence if I want to read fantasy, because I was reading what the books are about, like, online. I watch all these booktubers, right? So whenever they speak about a book, I go to Goodreads and read about it. Or whenever I see them reading online in Goodreads, I click on the book and read about it. So I read about a lot of books online today, and I realized that a lot of books have violence in them. Yeah, and if I'm going to be, like, scared of that, then I think I won't be able to read a lot of books. So I think I should just be okay with the fact that there is going to be violence, and try to make up my mind that there's going to be violence and it's okay, and I should just be okay with that, because it's just a book, it's just a story, and read it. Yeah, like, idea of powerless, right? Now I feel that powerless is just like other fantasy books, and I think that's how fantasy books are. So I think I should just pick it up again and read it. Yeah, I don't know, I'm so weird, right? Like, and even like romance books, like I told you, right, I started reading romance like 2 years ago. Till then I've just read children's book and young adult books. So after I started reading romance book, I realized like there's just a lot of sexual content, and I think that's how it is. I don't know, like, I think that's how it is, and I should just be okay with that, and I should not have too much of opinions. Yeah, I know I'm, like, really opinionated, and I have a lot of opinions on things, and I think that this is how it is, and I should just be okay with it. Yeah. I feel that I should just be okay with it and just read it. And I might like it because so many people like those books. So, yeah, they like it for a reason, right? Like, all these people like so many books. Like, yeah, like, so I think they like it for a reason. So I think I should just be okay with the fact that there's going to be these topics. And I should just read it. Yeah, I should just read it. Yeah, so I was thinking about that today. And also, I'm so sorry about the background noise. I can't do anything. I stay with my parents. This is the regular noise. Yeah, I don't know if you can hear it, but yeah, I'm getting distracted. Yeah, so what else is happening? Yeah, so my periods got over yesterday and I'm like so happy that it's over. Yeah, so you should actually log your period in a period app. Like there's like apps for that and it's like so handy. Like I always log my period in my period app. Like I've been doing that from years, and if when I log it there, like you get a notification when you're going to get your periods and you can just log how many days and all that stuff, and you get a notification before getting your period that yeah, your period, you're gonna get your period soon, so you can just be ready, like oh okay, I'm gonna get it, so I'm just gonna be ready. Yeah, so that's what I do and that's what I've been doing since many years now. Hi, hello, today is Sunday, today I am going to the temple. Yeah, so I just got ready to go to the temple. Yesterday I was watching all the YouTubers' videos, right? So Steph was eating pizza and I felt like eating it, so I ordered pizza and I had yesterday. And then yeah, Sarah was drinking matcha. Yeah, so I feel like drinking it too, so today I'm gonna go to a cafe to drink matcha and then later go to the temple and then come back. So that's the plan for today. I badly want to drink matcha tea, but it's not there anywhere where I live, so I thought like okay, let me just go to a cafe and there's a temple nearby, go to the temple and come back. Yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do today. I think that's why they're called as influencers, because whatever they do I feel like doing it too. Yeah, so so today I feel like doing that. And I think Rachel, Sarah and everyone, they shop from this website called as Princess Polly. Yeah, they have like really amazing clothes, but I think I can't shop from there. I think it's like a website only in Australia and US, I guess, I'm not sure. So yeah, so when I go to Australia, I'll probably shop from Princess Polly. I'm so excited to shop from there because Rachel has some really amazing clothes. Her clothes are so amazing, and even Sarah's clothes are so amazing. And yeah, I feel like shopping from there. Yeah, so yeah, that's why they're called as influencers, because whatever they do, I feel like doing it too. Yeah, so what else is happening? Yeah, so I am so happy that Audible updated their app. Yeah, so they updated the app and now there's like a discover tab in Audible, and if you click on that, according to the genre that you like, you can get all the books recommendation, and you can browse through all the categories and books and everything, which is so amazing. They didn't have this feature before, and yesterday I realized they added this feature and it's like so good. I can just go on to discover tab and discover all the books that they have in their catalog and choose from that. And I got to know that they have so many books, and I was like downloading so many books yesterday. I downloaded so many books. Yeah, so let me just tell you what all books I downloaded on Audible. Like I have so many that I would like to listen to. Yeah, you be here. Let me just open Audible. Oh, you can't stick see me, right? Yeah, so Audible. Library. What all have I downloaded? I downloaded this book. It's called a Summer Romance by Annabel Monaghan. Yeah, I downloaded that. I downloaded that book. And then I downloaded Fourth Wing and Iron Flame, book 1 and 2. So I downloaded Anxious People by Frederick Bachman. I downloaded The House in the Caribbean Sea by T.J. Klune. Out on a Limb by Hannah Bonin Young. And right now I'm listening to The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. Then I downloaded The Night Circus by Eric Morgenstern, The Starless Sea by Eric Morgenstern, and I have all these Harry Potter books that I'm like halfway through. I still have to listen to them. So these are the books that I downloaded on Audible, and I'm like so happy with the app that they have updated. So happy. And also now you don't really have to call the customer support to cancel the membership and renew the membership. You can just do it on Play Store, because that's how you take the membership and cancel the membership now. You can just like cancel the subscription on Play Store and like renew the subscription whenever you want it to. So they have added that feature, which is like really good. Everything is going good. Yeah, I'm just happy with what they have done to Audible. And I just wish that even Goodreads could make some changes, then it would be great. Yeah, it would be great if Goodreads also could make some changes. Yeah. So, that's what's been happening. Yeah, so now I'm just gonna go to the temple. Let me just turn off my laptop. Yeah, I'm just gonna go to the temple now. I'm gonna be like so exhausted by the time I come back. I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna be so exhausted. Yeah, I'm just wearing this plain black t-shirt with my high waist jeans. This is what I'm wearing. Yeah, so I'm just gonna be so exhausted by the time I come back, but I don't want to like sit at home. So I think it's better if I just go out and drink my matcha tea and read my book and go to the temple and then come back. The temple opens at 4:30. Now it's 1:30. So go till 4:30, I'll be like having my lunch, reading my book and bopping around. Yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do. And I think I should carry my umbrella because it might rain today. I checked the weather forecast and it might rain today. So I should probably carry my umbrella as well. So I'm carrying this huge bag so that I can carry my umbrella, carry my book and everything. Yeah, so I'm all set. I'm just like drinking my coffee and listening to music. Today I didn't feel tired by traveling because most of the time I traveled in auto, and only on top of the flyover the autos don't go. So I took a bus just to travel on top of the flyover and then again in auto. So as long as I do that, I don't really feel tired. So, and I just came back home by 5:30. Perfect. Yeah, so I went to the temple, I prayed, and then I went to Third Wave Cafe. Like in Bangalore, I think only in Third Wave Cafe you get matcha tea. I haven't seen it anywhere else. Like, it's not there in Starbucks, it's not there anywhere else that I went. I always see if matcha tea is there, but it's never there anywhere else. Yeah. So I went to Third Wave Cafe to drink matcha tea, and it was so good. And I had a croissant. Yeah, that was also very good. It was very nice, and I was just sitting there. I thought I'll read for some time, but I didn't read. I was just sitting there listening to music for some time, and then I went to the temple at 4:30, and I just came back home, and I reached by 5:30. It was like perfect peaceful day, and I think I'm gonna go to the temple every Sunday. I'm gonna make it a ritual to go to the temple every Sunday. Yeah, so it's gonna be fun. Yeah, like it's gonna be fun. So that's the plan right now. I'm so happy today. Yeah, I had like therapy session in the morning, then I was listening to music, and then I went to the temple. I had really good food at home. So I'm just so happy and grateful and thankful. I'm so happy today. Yeah. Like, I'm not happy like every single day. So whenever I'm happy, I'm like very grateful that I'm happy. So today I'm like really happy. Yeah. So, oh, did you see Taylor Swift made her relationship Instagram official? She's never done that before. Till date, she's never posted a picture of her boyfriend on her Instagram. And this is like the first time. And yesterday when she posted that picture, I was just staring at it. I was feeling so happy because she's never done that before. And she did it yesterday and I was like, yeah, I was like so happy to see that. Yeah, so she made it Instagram official and I'm like so happy for her. Like, very happy. Yeah, so very happy to see her like that. So that happened. I'm feeling so happy today. I don't know what to do now. I have to like always keep deleting stuff. Like, I'm always deleting or clearing clutter or decluttering. I'm always cleaning. Like, it's either my phone or my apps. Like, I have like a problem. Like, I'm always like cleaning, organizing, decluttering, throwing things away, throwing like waste away. Like, I think it's kind of like self-care for me, because I have to like always keep everything clean and neat. Like, even myself, like my hair and everything, like everything should be clean and neat all the time. And if I'm wearing like a dress and I feel like I'm not looking good in that dress, I'm like, I immediately go and change. Yeah, like I cannot, like, even if it is at home, if I feel like I'm not looking good in a dress, I just go and change. And I keep donating all my clothes, like whatever I don't wear, I just keep donating it. Yeah, I'm like always organizing, decluttering, cleaning. Like, yeah, and it kind of helps me helps my anxiety and helps me in a certain way. Like, I feel like, I don't know why I do that, but I feel so satisfied when I do that. And even when I'm like taking my medicine and I'm like marking as done, and if I'm like putting a task in the calendar and I'm always so excited to mark it as done and clean the calendar. And even when I'm like talking to my therapist, I write down everything in my notes app, and I'm always like cleaning every single time I talk to her about something. I just like backspace, 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 and delete, delete, delete. And I feel so satisfied when I do like simple things like this, like, which is like cleaning, organizing, like putting a line across something, that across a task that I have done. Things like that, like, it makes me so happy to do things like that. Yeah, like, I'm really weird like that. Yeah, so I'm really weird like that. Yeah. What else is happening, Rachna? Yeah, I think I have to pick up the books that I DNF'd. I think it's like the right book, wrong time. It happens to me, like, most of the time. It always happens to me. Like, it's always right book, wrong time. It's not that the book is bad. It's always right book, wrong time. I won't be in, like, in a mind space to read certain books at a time, and I DNF it. And these days, I have this very annoying habit where if I DNF it, I don't want it on my bookshelf. I immediately go to Blossoms and return it. I shouldn't do that. I'm like so into decluttering, organizing, clearing out the clutter and all that. Like, I always go and give it to Blossoms these days. I shouldn't have done that, because now I feel like reading it. Like, I feel like reading certain books that I DNF'd, like Powerless and Powerless by Elsie Silver and Powerless by Lauren Roberts. I feel like reading it now, and I don't have it because I gave it to Blossoms. Yeah, I'm kind of like that. It's always like right book, wrong time, because at certain time I won't be in like in a mind space to read it, because there'll be like certain topics which trigger me. Then I keep it. I should probably keep it for some more time in my bookshelf and see if I change my mind, if I'm like in the mind space to read it. Because I feel that as the time goes, and as I grow as a person, and as I gain a lot of understanding on a certain topic, I feel like I'm able to accept things which I wouldn't have accepted in the past. Like books. I'm talking about books. Yeah. So I feel that like I'm like really childish sometimes. Like I think it's because of the books that I was reading and the content that I was watching. I used to always watch children's content and I read young adult book and children's book. So I think that's why I didn't really understand how adults function and what are the adult topics that books have. Like I feel that it is quite normal to have sexual content in adult book, because like adults, you're like an adult, so this is kind of something that happens, but I am not used to it, so I felt it a bit weird at first to accept it, because I'm weird, like because I was immature. And also, I've never been in a proper relationship. I've never been in a proper relationship. I've been in love, but it didn't really progress too much. Yeah. And I've always been an August girly, so it didn't really progress too much. So I never understood that part of a relationship, like where you progress in the relationship. Like I've always like never understood that, because I've never experienced it myself. So I think that's why it was a bit hard for me to accept those kind of topics in books. But I think it is pretty normal. Like I feel that after I grow up some more, and after I experience being in a long-term relationship and experiencing things like that, I will be able to like understand it better. But now I feel like I'm a bit immature and childish, so that's why I'm like not able to like what I'm trying to say, right? Like I'm a bit immature and childish because I haven't experienced a lot of things, and I feel like I'm still like very childish, and I need to grow up some more for me to accept a lot of things and understand and learn. Yeah, like I don't know if it made sense, but that's what I feel. So I feel that it's actually my fault. It's not that it is not a good book or the topics are not right, in a sense. I feel it's like it's me. It's because I am different and I still need a lot of exposure and growing up to do to understand and like, you know. Yeah, I feel it's me. Yeah, that's what I realized yesterday. I realized it yesterday when I was reading all these topics about what was I reading? Fantasy books. And I realized like all fantasy books have violence. So I think it was not that Pavlis was bad. It's me. Like I didn't understand that this is what fantasy is. Like I didn't really understand that concept because I've never read fantasy, and the only fantasy I've read is Harry Potter. And Harry Potter, you know, right? It's a children's book, so it is very cozy and nice. So I think it is me that is a problem, not the book. Yeah. It's always me that is a problem. I always have personal problems with books. It's not the book that is a problem. I never feel that any book is bad. It's always me who's not in the right time frame to read that. Yeah, because I am very different and I have a lot of... Yeah, so it's always me. It's not them. Yeah, it's always me. Yeah, I that's what I feel. Yeah, so that's it that I wanted to tell you today. So it was really nice spending the weekend with you. I had fun. Probably I'll start taking a vlog tomorrow or tonight. Let's see. Yeah, and we'll always be in touch. And thank you so much for watching my videos. It means the world to me. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for showing me so much love. And I'll come back with another video sometime soon. So till then, please do like, share and subscribe, because it's all free and it'll make me happy. So I'll see you. Bye.